New Year's Eve is a time to raise your glass with your friends and family, but many times it's hard to figure out just what to say during a toast. But here to give us a crash course in toasting is Make a Toast founders Katrin Kern and Chris Corbell. Good morning to you both, and Happy New Year.
Happy
New Year.
Crystal.
Happy New Year.
Chris, let's start with you. Making a toast, it's not as easy as it looks if you haven't thought about it, haven't recited it, and somebody all of a sudden tells you you need to make a toast.
Oh my gosh, it is so hard. And New Year's Eve is particularly difficult because most people don't realize that New Year's Eve has a particular purpose when you're giving a New Year's Eve toast, and there's certain themes that are just inherent to the holiday.
All right, so what are some things that, some do's and don'ts for giving a toast?
Well, for example, we have lovely Miss Kim Kardashian, who's been mentioned on the news many times this morning.
Well, several times.
Well, she is a beautiful girl, but she does tend a little bit to be all about me, 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 which is where you don't want to go when you're making a toast.
Okay.
What you do want to do is you want to remind all your listeners that everyone has reason to be proud of themselves for everything that they've done in the last 365 days, and that 2012 is going to be everyone's time to shine.
All right, so praise others and don't focus on yourself.
Not yourself alone. It's all about the collective and everybody's new year.
All right, Chris, go ahead.
And you know, another great thing is the theme is optimism. Mm-hmm. So if you're offering just something upbeat to feel good about, to feel grateful about, it gets everyone feeling so great about the new year.
You know, and everybody always has a sort of those bad stories when unfortunately they've had just a little too much to drink. They get up before their friends and family and start telling stories that they probably shouldn't.
Well, we actually call this the Lindsay Lohan. And we say instead of doing the Lindsay Lohan, mm-hmm. we suggest a safer way to keep it real is to get high on your spirit of the occasion and your sense of celebration.
And finally, before we let you guys go, you guys have a formula to make sure that all of this goes without a hitch.
It's called the Cheers formula.
Yes, C-H-E-E-R-S.
The C stands for confidence.
Okay.
If you want to convince us, you have to believe it first.
H is for hope. You've got to deliver big on this on New Year's Eve.
E is for energy. You got to come from a place of joy.
And the second E is for engage. Make sure that you can be heard and that you can make eye contact.
R is for rehearse. If it's important to say, it's important to practice saying it.
And S is for speak only from the heart. And if you can follow this, you're going to make an amazing toast that's beautiful and inspirational and memorable.
Fantastic. Well, before we let you two go, in case our folks out there want some more tips, more information, is there a website they can go check out?
Absolutely. Our website is www.makeatoast.com. So it's makeatoast.com. And there is a lot of free advice on our blog right there.
Thank you both so much for joining us this morning. Hopefully your tips will help some folks redeem themselves from some of the speeches they've given in years past.
I hope so. Happy New Year.
Have a great New Year,
everyone.